Welcome inside Lawler Rink. It's Boston University coming to North Andover to face off against the Merrimack College Warriors. It's been the hottest start in program history for the Warriors. So far, they're 3-0-1. They defeated Union 2 weeks ago, the last time they were up here at Lawler Rink, a 3-0 victory in the season opener. They defeated Union 4-1 in the following day. Last week, they're out in Happy Valley. They went 1-0-1 against the Penn State Nittany Lions. They started off with a tie, a 1-1 game, and then they defeated Penn State 2-1 last Saturday afternoon. For the Boston University Terriers, they are 0-1-1, 0-1 in hockey, just two games under their belt, a loss to Northeastern, a 5-0 shutout, and then a 3-3 tie last Saturday. As we see the starting lineups right now, about to be introduced by the public address announcer right here at Lawler Rink, home game number 3 on the season for the Warriors, who are 3-0-1, and this will be their first Hockey East matchup so far this season. For Boston University, they'll have their number 1 line starting for the forwards. It'll be Sammy Davis, Jesse Comfer, and Courtney Correa, the freshman out of Whitby, Ontario. The defenders will be Brianna Scarpese and Abby Stanley. And in goal will be Corinne Schroeder, the sophomore of Elm Creek, Manitoba. So far, she's given up 8 goals in just 2 games, a save percentage of .887. The head coach for BU is Brian DeRocha. He's in his 14th year, all 14 years for Boston University, an overall record of 269-156. For the Merrimack Warriors, they'll have their second starting line. Yeah. Katelyn Ray, the senior out of Whitby, a product of the Whitby Wolves. She'll be joined by Michaela Grant-Mentis and Gabby Jones. The defenders will be Paige Sorensen and Dominique Kramer. And in net will be Samantha Ridgewell, the senior goaltender out of Outlook, Saskatchewan. She's been great so far for the Warriors. As we continue on the Total Sports Repair Hockey pregame show, Total Sports Repair Hockey in Salem, New Hampshire, your complete source for the very best in hockey equipment, sales, and service. This is the 10th meeting overall between these two schools. BU has a 7-2-0 edge over the Warriors. They met 3 times last year, in fact. BU took 2 of the 3 games, including the very first game these teams met at the beginning of the year. BU took it right here at Lawler Rink, and then the team split it at Walter Brown later in the year. As we see the introductions for the Merrimack Warriors, Gabby Jones, the freshman of Westfield, Massachusetts, so far with 3 assists on her young season. She's a 4-year member of the girls' hockey team at Williston, Northampton, and she was a league all-star. See Dominique Kramer out of West Fargo, North Dakota, the 5'6 senior. And as we mentioned, in goal, Samantha Ridgewell. She's been very good so far. Her goals against average, under 1 goal per contest, and a save percentage of .972. The Warriors so far have been led by Katelyn Ray and Michaela Grant-Mentis, and we'll continue with that right after the national anthem. As we welcome you back inside the broadcast booth, I'm Greg Kadetsky. Thank you for joining us tonight on the Hockey East opener for the Merrimack Warriors. Game number five for them. They are 3-0-1, as we mentioned already on the Total Sports Repair Hockey pregame show. Two wins against Union 2 weeks ago right here at Lawler Rink, where they only allowed one goal over the two games. And then out at Penn State, they went 0-1-0-1. Their last game on Saturday afternoon against the Nittany Lions, a 2-1 victory. For the BU Terriers, just two games under their belt. Two-game series with Northeastern. Northeastern won the first one 5-0. And then the Huskies and Terriers tied it. It was a dogfight, a 3-3 game last Saturday afternoon. The Merrimack Warriors are coached by Erin Hamlin. She's in her 11th year coaching overall, her fourth one here at Merrimack. Obviously, only 4 years of hockey existence here in North Andover for the women's ice hockey team right here at Merrimack College. Last year at home, the Warriors were 5-11-2. So far, they are 2-0 and trying to make it 3-0, and Grant Mentis will set up for the opening puck drop. 20 minutes on the clock, and we're set to go as BU will control the tip-off. They're going to go right to left on your screen. This is Stanley. 15 minutes into this game, the 10th meeting overall between Boston University and Merrimack College. And here come the Terriers dressed in their red uniforms with white numbers. Merrimack in their white uniforms with blue numbers trimmed with gold. As the puck in the defensive end for the Warriors, trying to clear it out. The Terriers trying to keep it in. Good job keeping it in by Correa, and she'll clear it right behind Samantha Ridgewell, the goaltender for the Warriors. 45 seconds gone by right here in the first period. Home game number three for the Warriors as the Terriers clear it out. Trying to start something in the back, trying to run to it is Manu, and she controls it right behind her, right behind Ridgewell, a dangerous circumstance right there. The Terriers keep control of it in the zone. 1 minute gone by here in the first period. As the Terriers are winless so far. Game number three on the season for them. The Warriors already have 3 wins under their belt. Last year, they had 11 total. And this is Dakari. She's new to the team, the freshman out of Saskatchewan. Gets the puck back right in the middle. Double-teamed as it taken away by the Terrier defense. A very strong BU defense. Coached by Brian DeRocher. As the centering pass couldn't be handled by Donnelly, a freshman out of Wellesley, Mass. Warriors trying to clear it out on the near board. Now behind Ridgewell. Terriers putting on full rink defense right now. They're not letting the Warriors clear out the puck. It's into the corner. Both teams battle for it. 2 minutes gone by here in the first period. BU's controlled the first 2 minutes. The wrister is kicked aside by Ridgewell. She just saw it at the last moment, and the Warriors will once again try to clear it out. It's on the puck of Volpe. She can't clear it. Good defense by Correa trying to keep it in the zone. Now the Warriors do clear it out, and the Terriers take it right back right at the center line. This is Sammy Davis, the redshirt junior. Warriors trying to clear it out. Again, Terriers clean it up right at the blue line. Now behind Ridgewell. ...17 minutes to go in this first period. Still no score as the Warriors finally clear out of the zone. It's been in the Warrior defensive zone the majority of this first 3 minutes and 4 seconds. And we see what the Terriers want to do. They want to attack, attack, attack. They did a good job in their game last Saturday against a very strong Northeastern Husky squad, and they tied it at 3. And that was the final outcome, putting 3 goals on the board. And they needed to do it. They got 2 early on. They got 3, pardon me, in the first period of that game. Northeastern is able to come back and get the tie. This is Schuler trying to get out of the zone. Instead, Grant Mentis. The wrister is knocked aside by Schroeder. Grant Mentis, the follow, is kicked up in the air. Warriors trying to keep it in the zone. This is Cook. Cook to Roust. Now behind the net, trying to find it is Katelyn Ray. Ray has it. Trying to shove it inside, back out. The long shot by Cook is blocked, and here comes Parker. Parker crossed the blue line, a one-on-two. Trying to keep the puck with her, and good defense, good poke check by the Warriors' defense. And Merrimack will reset. A good last 45 seconds for the Warriors, putting some pressure on the BU defense. This is Abby Cook. There's Abby Cook for BU, and there's Chloe Cook for the Warriors. As Ferguson crossing the line with a head of steam, slows it down, looks behind Schroeder. Warriors trying to keep it there. This is Sorensen. The shot is just wide. Ferguson, the tip, was cleaned up by Schroeder, and we'll have a face-off to the right of Corinne Schroeder. Schroeder, so far in just two games, has given up 8 goals, an average of 4 goals per game. When you look at Ridgewell on the other side, she's only given up 3 goals in 4 games. They're allowing 0.75 goals per game. Ridgewell has been fantastic for the Warriors, but it's on the side of Schroeder right now if the Warriors can keep it in. And here comes BU. Back and forth we go in the neutral zone. Great move there by Kramer. Slapper is poked aside by, it was Bokers. Here comes Courtney Maud trying to stuff it inside. Nothing there. And the reset goes to Manu. It's on the short boards. Battling for it is Courtney Maud. Quarter of the way through this first period. Still no score at Lawler Rink. The Warriors and Terriers are battling for the 10th time. The Warriors couldn't keep it in. Madison Morey, the senior, couldn't quite do it. The puck just passed the blue line into the neutral zone. Ridgewell collects it. Pass almost taken away. Good recovery by Courtney Maud, but here comes BU. This is Schuler. Crossing center ice. The slapper to the right, collected by Ridgewell. Loose puck in front. No one was there for the Terriers, and the Warriors will clear it out. This break in the action gives us an opportunity to thank our sponsors for their wonderful support of tonight's broadcast. Coach Company, the official bus company of Merrimack Athletics, Domino's, the Eagle Tribune, Enterprise Bank, Fred C. Church Insurance, and Fuddruckers, the world's greatest hamburgers. Face-off won by the Terriers, shot deflected wide by Ridgewell. And with that face-off, it's an interesting little point right now is that the Warriors have been very close with faceoffs won and faceoffs lost. In fact, coming into today's game, they had won 96 faceoffs and lost 95. So we'll see if they can win it now. We'll have a reset with a faceoff. As Emily Volpe was there for the Warriors, we'll do it again with 13:50 on the clock. Faceoff won for the second time in a row by the Terriers. This is Abby Stanley. The shot on Ridgewell is a turn shot. It was a blind shot. Ridgewell made the save, a quick reaction. 3 shots so far by both teams. Both goalies have knocked all 3 shots aside as the Warriors clear it out. This is Schuler near the red line. We'll just dump it behind Ridgewell. Both teams reset. Sorensen trying to clear it out for the Warriors. She cannot. trying to find Bonfey. The two of them are trying to get out of the zone. BU doing a terrific job keeping it in. A second opportunity right here for the Terriers. Pass to Abby Cook. The poke in front was just wide of Ridgewell. It was a great opportunity for the Terriers. This is Cook again. Looks to the left. The wrists are just wide of Ridgewell. BU putting a lot of pressure on the senior goaltender. She's blocked five. She's seen about four others go wide of her. The shot from the point, just wide of Ridgewell once again. That was Alex Allen. New to the team, the freshman defender out of British Columbia. No whistle, goes behind Schroeder, and the Terriers will reset. They've controlled the tempo of the game in the first 8 minutes here at Lawler Rink. As collecting is Manu behind the net. Pass a little short to Katelyn Ray. The team's leading scorer so far with 5 points, three goals in the first four games is Katelyn Ray. Terriers will reset. They're moving quickly. They have a little kick to their step. Here come the Terriers. Great move there right on Ridgewell. Ridgewell makes the save. Terrific reflexes by Samantha Ridgewell. 11:30 and counting to play in this first period. As Katelyn Ray can't collect it. Looking for Russ at the top is BU. The wrister is wide of Ridgewell. That was Galway. A pass out collected momentarily by Gabby Jones, the freshman, and she just dumps it right into the BU defensive zone. 9 minutes gone by. It's been all BU so far, but no score to show for it. Here comes Correa and lost it again. Good defense by Ferguson. Ferguson crossing the red line with a head of steam. Ferguson has Maud with her, trying to find her. Goes up top. The wrister deflected, and Abby Stanley comes away with it. Stanley trying to get it out of the zone. Second time Merrimack's put real pressure on Schroeder in the BU defense. Warriors trying to clear it out again. It's Dominique Kramer with the puck. Teams battling for it to the left of Ridgewell. Refs were able to see it, so no whistle was called, and it's cleared back out to the defensive zone of the Terriers. Here come the Warriors with a nice little break right now, but they had to clear it back out due to potential offsides. So as we pass through the halfway point of the first period, still no score between both teams. Warriors trying to keep it in the zone. Bonfey couldn't poke check it away from Schuler. Schuler's racing up and just dumps it behind Ridgewell. And Ridgewell now will collect it. Face off to the right of her with 9:31 to play in this first period. BU has controlled the tempo of this game, and you can see on the replay they are pushing it every chance they can. As Davis right there had an opportunity, Ridgewell knocked it aside, and we'll have a face off to the right of Ridgewell right now. As it's Bonfey lining up for the Warriors. Bonfey wins the faceoff. Trying to clear it out are the Warriors. It's Bonfey getting it back. Crossing the line with Bokers. And it looks to be offsides going against the Warriors. Quick opportunity to thank our wonderful sponsors for their support of tonight's broadcast, Haverhill Country Club, Holiday Inn Express of Andover and North Lawrence, Jackson Kitchen Designs, Jamie's Restaurant, La Quinta Inn and Suites, and Landers Electrical. 9:15 and counting remaining this first period. No score in the 10th meeting all time between the BU Terriers and the Merrimack Warriors. BU has a 7-2-0 advantage. We've not seen one of the first nine games end with a tie. Puck right in front of Schroeder. Knocked away. Good defense by the Terriers once again. The slapper was kicked aside. Paige Voigt with the puck behind. Trying to find her teammate. It's in the hands of Dakari. Dakari to Manu. And Donnelly takes it away. Good defense by the Terriers once again. 6-3 so far. The Terriers lead it with the shots, but still no score. That's where it's most important. So Warriors poke check it away in the neutral zone. Here comes Katelyn Ray. Ray crossing the blue line, trying to set something up. Losing the puck. It's flipped up in the air. Grant Mentis couldn't come away with it. And BU will try to clear it out once again. Ray has other ideas. As a penalty upcoming, as Grant Mentis was pushed into the boards, it'll be the first power play of the game, and this one will belong to the Merrimack Warriors. They are 1-for-11 so far in the season in power plays, as we see the penalty right here against Courtney Correa, the freshman forward of Whitby, Ontario. So Grant Mentis will try to win the faceoff for the Merrimack Warriors. She cannot. Galway clears it right behind the net. And the Terriers clear it out of the zone. So both teams will have to reset. Here comes Grant Mentis once again as we cross the 8-minute mark of the first period. Grant Mentis right along the boards. Big hit right in the corner. She was able to get up. And once again, the Terriers clear it out. 30 seconds gone by so far on this power play. As Ferguson can't get it, and it'll be an icing call going against the Warriors. These two teams met just one time here at Lawler Rink last year. The Boston University Terriers took that matchup. They met two other times down in Walter Brown Arena, and the team split those games. BU won two of the three meetings last year. So far in this first meeting, teams are tied 0-0. The first hockey matchup of the year for the Warriors, the second one, maybe the third one for the Terriers, as the first two games were against the Northeastern Huskies. This is Kramer going to Volpe. Warriors trying to set something up. McLean. The centering pass just wide, as short of the eye. Opportunity right there with Voigt. Second chance right here for the Warriors. Volpe. Down low, centering pass. Great save by Schroeder. She does it, but it's in. The Warriors with a power play goal. It's 6:47 remaining in the first period. It looks like it was knocked in by Jessica Bonfey. We'll see on the replay. And there are about five players right in front, but it was the third chance for the Warriors that knocked it in. And it looks like on the second it would be Emily Volpe who might be credited with a goal. So Merrimack takes a 1-0 lead on the power play goal, their second power play goal of the season. Now 2 of 12 in that category, and more importantly, a 1-0 lead over the BU Terriers. Even though BU is controlling the first 8 minutes of this game, the Warriors are the first ones to light up the scoreboard. The puck goes into the stands. Well, a face-off. What an effort by the Warriors, staying with it. It was the same setup they ran about 10 seconds prior, where it was just in front of Schroeder. No one could knock it home. This time they crashed everybody inside. And with the goal was Emily Volpe, her first one of the season. Even strength for both teams right now, 6-10 and counting your men in the first period. The shot is right through Ridgewell, a blind shot by Abby Cook, and just like that, the Terriers tie it at one. Abby Cook's first goal of the season. They always say you set up a screen right in front. As we see on the replay, it went back to Abby Cook at the point. She had the wrister, and there's a few screens right in front. And with that goal, she was able to tie this game at once. The Warriors had the lead briefly for about 34 seconds, but the Terriers tie it up quickly. 1-1 is the score. Little rush right now by Dakari. The freshman, the shot on short of the rebound is knocked aside. Oh, we could have had three goals in a matter of 50 seconds, just inches away. The Warriors trying to keep it and push it back into the zone. They do. Here comes Comfer, crossing the blue line. Comfer out of Illinois, controlling the puck, working it to Correa. Now it's the Warriors' turn to try to get it out of the zone. They do. It's on the stick of Katelyn Ray. Katelyn Ray, the team's leading scorer. And we have a whistle and a penalty upcoming with 5:05 remaining in the first period. It's going to be another power play for the Merrimack Warriors. They're 1-for-1 today. And that penalty will go against Abby Stanley. Her third penalty so far in this young season for the redshirt junior out of St. Louis. The Warriors didn't waste any time to take advantage of the one-man advantage last time. We'll see what they have up their sleeves this time. As we're under 5 minutes to play in this first period, that period that got exciting over the last 2 minutes. Both teams, you could say, pretty much even over the last three or four, though BU controlled the first 8 to 10 minutes of this game. As McLean loses it, goes all the way back to Ridgewell. 30 seconds gone by on this power play. McLean finding Gabby Jones, the freshman. Trying to poke it in front. Now it's Katelyn Ray racing to the puck. She's one of the fastest skaters in Hockey East as Ray couldn't knock it home. As the net got dislodged, but it will continue play. About halfway through this power play for the Warriors as they'll reset behind Samantha Ridgewell. Big pass. Katelyn Ray loses it at the blue line. Here come the Terriers once again, shorthanded, almost getting by Ridgewell as that shot by Comfer. As Gabby Jones will reset. Pass goes to Grant Mentis. Mentis along the boards. Grant Mentis gets it back. Give and go. Taken away by BU. Good defense there by Scarpese. And racing to get it is Chloe Cook. And now it's Abby Cook for BU. No relation between the two Cook players on the ice right now. Abby Cook for BU and Chloe Cook for Merrimack, even though both are juniors and both from British Columbia. 3 minutes remaining in the first period. Merrimack couldn't take advantage in this power play. Now 1-for-2 in the game. And it will be icing against the Merrimack Warriors. We'll bring the puck all the way down to the other side of Lawler Rink. We've seen action on both sides of the rink so far. Merrimack wins the faceoff, goes behind Ridgewell, and off the high boards, it goes all the way back near Schroeder. It'll be icing once again. So 11 seconds after we just had an icing call against the Warriors, we'll do it again. But this time, the faceoff will be to the left of Samantha Ridgewell. Special thanks today to Merrimack Graduate and Professional Studies, Micros Northeast, Mr. Takeout, Palmer's Restaurant and Tavern, Park Street Pub and Grill, and Patriot Energy Group. The Warriors trying to get it out of the zone. BU's other ideas, and it slips right by Ridgewell. Another goal for BU, this one by Reagan Rust. Ridgewell had trouble seeing. It looked like a knuckler off of the stick of Rust, and a goal for BU. 2-1 Terriers, just like that. And it's been those long shots that Ridgewell has had trouble with. It was Cook with the wrist, or in that time, Rust, with her first goal of the season. So Merrimack all of a sudden finds themselves down 2-1, even though they had a one-goal lead after the power play about 4 minutes ago. Merrimack trying to answer BU and try to keep it in the zone. The slapper is blocked right in front. Warriors trying to keep it in. Here comes BU once again. Comfer with the puck, crossing the red line. It was a momentary man advantage for the Terriers, but the reason they had the man advantage was because one of the players was offside. So we'll have a faceoff outside of the defensive zone for the Warriors, 2:05 on the clock. Terriers with a 2-1 advantage. Ferguson trying to win it for BU. Instead, the Terriers win the faceoff, bring it back. It's Abby Cook who controls it. She had the first BU goal of this game. Dakari, the freshman, trying to leave it for Ferguson. Ferguson, the centering pass to Dakari, just wide of Schroeder. The follow is kicked aside by the goaltender of the Terriers. Once again, this is Dakari, the freshman, looking to Manu. Dakari will settle behind Schroeder. Minute 30 remaining in the first period. BU on top 2-1. Manu, the wrister just wide. The follow is cleaned up by Corinne Schroeder. BU has the advantage on shots. They also have the advantage on goals. 2-1, the Terriers are on top of the Warriors. Minute 23 remaining in this first period. Grant Mentis will try to win this faceoff. We'll do it again as 13-13 on the faceoff. Grant Mentis versus Natasha Tarnowski. This time it's Katelyn Ray. Ray wins the tip. This is Sorensen. It's the face-off, pardon me, and we'll have another face-off. So with 1:19 remaining in the first period, we had a penalty against the Warriors. Gabby Jones will go to the penalty box, her third penalty in her young career. And game number 5 for the Warriors. So 2 minutes on the clock for the power play for the Terriers. 1:19 remaining in the first period. And we'll have another face-off. Grant Mentis facing off against Comfer. Both players battling for the puck. Closing in on a minute to play in this first period. The slapper just by Ridgewell. Cook was trying to set up her teammate. This is Davis going behind Ridgewell and clear it out. So far, the Warriors doing a good job killing this penalty. They have not allowed a power play goal so far this season. Teams have had 11 times, now make it 12 to try to get a power play goal. BU is 30 seconds before the end of the first period. Cook at the top, looking to the left. Ridgewell somehow collects it. She didn't see it in front, and it was a more of look what I found in my glove. And with 22 seconds remaining in the first period, we'll have another faceoff. Tenth shot of the first period for the Terriers to Merrimack 6. The Terriers have gotten 2 shots behind Ridgewell, trying to make it 3 right here on the power play. Faceoff won by the Terriers. It's up to Rust. And we have a whistle. Looks like it'll be offsides against the Terriers. The puck just slipped past the blue line. 18 seconds remaining in this first period. Trying to win the faceoff is Bonfi. She does, but it goes behind to Paige Voigt. Now behind Ridgewell. 10 seconds left in the first period. It's cleared out. Both teams will race for it. Final 3 seconds tick away in this first period that the Boston University Terriers have a 2-1 advantage over the Merrimack Warriors. A back and forth first half. The Terriers controlled the tempo in the first 12 minutes. Merrimack struck first, but the Terriers got the last two goals of the period, tying at one on a goal by Abby Cook. And then just a few moments later, Reagan Rust with her first goal of the game gave the Terriers a 2-1 advantage, and that's where we stand right now. We'll take a quick break right now, and we'll come back with some more stats of the first period, some out-of-town scores, and we'll have the second half when we return right here at Lawler Rink. 2-1, the BU Terriers have the lead over the Merrimack Warriors. Welcome back inside Lawler Rink. We are at the first intermission as the BU Terriers lead the Merrimack Warriors by a score of 2-1. We'll look at the highlights of the first period so far. It was started by the Merrimack Warriors, a power play goal at the very beginning by Emily Volpe, and we see the scrum right in front, and Volpe was able to knock it home. And a first power play goal for the Warriors, the first goal of the game. And then BU, just 43 seconds later, Abby Cook from the point. It was a wrister, as you can see here. Ridgewell was screened. It got behind Ridgewell, and BU is able to tie it at one. Take another look on that Cook goal. You could tell Ridgewell didn't even see it at the beginning. And then 3.5 minutes later, Reagan Rust gets in the action, her first goal of the season. And it kind of caught Ridgewell a little off, another kind of screen that BU set up. And those shots on goal, they started out high for BU. Merrimack came back, got it within three in that category, 10-7. Power plays, Merrimack 1-for-2, BU 0-for-1. Faceoffs won pretty even. BU is 111, Merrimack 10, and three blocks for the Terriers, and just one for the Warriors. There are some out-of-town scores right now in men's hockey. Merrimack and Bentley tied at one in Waltham. Down in Providence, Rhode Island at Schneider Arena, the Friars are on top of the Crusaders of Holy Cross, 3-0. That game is in the third period, halfway through that final frame. UNH and UConn battling up in Durham, New Hampshire, 2-2 at the end of one period of play up in the Granite State. And another Hockey East action, BC, we have an update on the score. BC is a 2-1 lead, and it is a final as the Eagles win it in overtime over St. Lawrence. Three more games remaining on the docket. Maine with a 7-0 victory over Sacred Heart. Vermont and Quinnipiac tied at one in the third period. Got halfway through the third period up in Burlington, Vermont. And the other game going on is Colgate Northeastern. Colgate with a 1-0 lead over the Huskies. That being played at Matthews Arena. Right here at Lawler Rink, we get set for the second period. As Merrimack finds themselves down 2-1, both teams switch sides. The Terriers will go left to right. The Warriors will go right to left. And we have Grant Mentis and Schuler on a puck drop. And we're set to go with a nice clean sheet of ice here in the second period. Here come the Terriers bringing it out. It's a 2-1 advantage for the Boston University Terriers. Looking for their first victory of the season so far. 1-0-1-1. This is Cook at the top above Ridgewell. A slapper by Abby Cook. Cook all the way to the other side of Lawler Rink. The Terriers will collect it. Collected by Allen. We didn't mention her name a lot in the first period, maybe at the beginning a couple of times. As the Warriors just bring it back out. Terriers trying to dump it into the zone. Here come the Warriors. This is Paige Voigt along the short board. Ferguson now right in front. The follow is just to the right of Schroeder. Terriers trying to clear it out. Minute 15 gone by in the second period. So here come the Warriors collecting it. Spinning it out is Paige Voigt. Manu knocks it off the boards right in front of the Terrier bench. This is Chloe Cook collecting it. Just gets it past the blue line, so the Terriers will have to reset, bring everyone out from the offensive side. Manu behind Ridgewell. Good poke check there by Worthrich, the freshman of Anchorage, Alaska. Terriers put in some pressure on. They did it in the first couple of minutes of the first period. Couldn't get a goal out of that in that instance. They did get two later on in the period, and that's how we're at a 2-1 score. Manu finding her teammate. Here come the Terriers with numbers, centering pass. No one there, and Madison Morey knocks it away. Here comes Schuler. Scarpese. The wrister just kicked aside by Ridgewell. That one she saw. Scarpese to Stanley. Her shot is blocked right in front. Worthrich once again. And now the Warriors get the puck by Maddie Burton. Collecting it is Chloe Cook near center ice. No penalty as players fall down. Good defense there by Paige Sorensen. Stopping the little break by BU. It was Correa who had the nice little rush. As the Warriors tried to clear it out, it hit one of the linesmen, and it goes right into the BU bench, and we have a whistle with 16:48. Remaining in the second period, BU holding on to a 2-1 advantage. Comfort trying to win the faceoff against Volpe. Cleared back into the Warrior zone. Here comes Sorensen. Sorensen along the near boards. Cleared back to Ridgewell. 3.5 gone by here in the second period. Centering pass, no one there. It was kind of dumped right in front by the Terriers. They couldn't have the deflection go by Ridgewell. And finally, the Warriors try to clear it out, and they do. It's on the stick of Emily Volpe. Collecting in the back is Schroeder. Here come the Terriers, 4 minutes gone by in the second period. Abby Cook dumps it down, and it's Dominique Kramer. Jones now gives it to Grant Mentis, who knocks it down near center ice. Grant Mentis with a head of steam. Brings it back out to Kramer. To the left to Roust. Slapper up top, almost by Schroeder. She didn't see it. It was a bouncing puck. Grant Mentis, the shot kicked aside by Schroeder, and we'll have a penalty going against the Terriers of BU. So another power play for the Warriors. They went 1-for-2 in the first period. In the first power play, they scored a goal. As Reagan Rust, who had the second goal for the BU Terriers, will spend the next 2 minutes in the penalty box, barring a goal, a power play goal by the Merrimack Warriors. As Ferguson lines up for the faceoff, trying to win it, she can't, the Terriers do. Clear it behind Schroeder. McLean trying to keep it in for the Warriors. She cannot. Puck goes behind Ridgewell. No icing. As Voigt collects it. Almost lost in the defensive zone, and BU will just wisely bring it back out. Take some time off of the power play for the Warriors. There comes Kramer. Kramer crossing the red line. Now the blue line. Stopping. Trying to find a teammate. Finds Chloe Cook. Kept in the zone. Now poke checked away by the Terrier defense. Strong defense by BU. Kramer can't keep it in with her glove. Here come the Terriers. 2-on-2 break right now as Schuler has her pass knocked aside. And here comes Chloe Cook and the Warriors. She hurries. They have numbers. instead, Cook just dumps it down as we have 50 seconds. Run on the power play for Merrimack. 1 for 2 so far on the power play. Gabby Jones, the freshman, twirls and brings it back to Cook, who will bring it back to Jones. The freshman already has 3 assists so far in the season. Long pass finds Grant Mentis. Grant Mentis. Give it to Gabby Jones. The shot is just wide. 20 seconds remaining on the power play, and the Terriers clear it all the way out back to Samantha Ridgewell. Sorensen takes a peek at the clock. It shows 9 remaining on the power play. Now 8. And the Warriors will just reset and let this power play expire. So they're 1 for 3 with a man advantage. And the dump down pass is collected by BU. Behind Schroeder, kind of to the right of her. As collecting is Davis. Great skating by Sammy Davis. Taking it herself, trying to shoot on Ridgewell, shot deflected wide. Terrific skating there by Sammy Davis, somehow holding on to the puck. Terriers keeping it in the zone, 7 minutes gone by here in the second period. The wrist around Ridgewell is just wide by Scarpese. The second shot is knocked aside by Ridgewell. Here come the Warriors. Line change for the Merrimack. The puck is dropped behind Ridgewell. We have an icing with 12:27 remaining in the second period. Terriers still on top, 2-1. An opportunity to thank our wonderful sponsors for their support of tonight's broadcast. Pepsi, Ruggeri's Roast Beef, Schrödinger Real Estate, Merrimack College Bookstore, Sodesco Dining, and the Sonesta Hotel in Andover. 12:55 and counting men in the second period. Just one penalty against both teams here in the period. It was a penalty against BU as this puck hits the rafters of Lawler Rink. If you're familiar with the other rinks here in Hockey East, this one is the shortest. If you're going from the rink up, it is the shortest by far in Hockey East, especially if you compare it to, again, a Serena or any of the big arenas. This is a small one. In fact, the ice is the smallest of any ice surface in Hockey East. It gets very intimate here, especially when it is packed here for men's and women's hockey games. Great skating there by Ferguson. Trying to dump it behind Schroeder. She cannot. Merrimack with another opportunity. Terriers trying to clear it out of the zone. Worthridge trying to collect it for the Terriers. Instead, it was in front of Voigt. She couldn't see it. Schroeder collects it, and we'll have a face-off just to the side of Corinne Schroeder, who has seen 7 shots. She's seen 6 of them. Take a look at Paige Sorensen, and now the Warriors trying to win this face-off in the BU defensive zone. Here comes Bonfi. He'll come on to attempt to win this faceoff. Bonfi does. Cleared back up to the top of McLean. The wrister is just wide by Bukolska. As Schroeder knocks it to the side. Here come the Terriers, who will reset. 11:15 and counting in the second period. Here come the Warriors now. Bonfi with the puck. Handing it off to Gabby Jones. Here come the Warriors again. Katelyn Rett, team's leading scorer, dumps it to the left of Schroeder. Ray's been quiet so far. First on the team with 5 points. Grantman just behind her with 3 goals. Terriers trying to keep it, get it out of the zone. The Warriors have other ideas. And now it's back into the neutral zone. This is Cook. Taken away by the Warriors. They want to move quickly. It's Gabby Jones who has it taken away. Katelyn Ray battling for it again. As we're closing in on the halfway point of this period and the halfway point of this hockey game. The shot is just wide. It hit the side post. Comfer was going in on Ridgewell. Davis now collecting it. Shot right in front. It was Comfer there. She had it taken away. BU putting some pressure on Ridgewell. Dumping in his Scarpese. Ridgewell will collect and reset. This is Paige Voigt. Voigt with some teammates. Trying to keep the pressure on. This is Maud. And she'll bring it back to Manu. Voigt can't collect it. Goes behind Schroeder. 9-10 and counting men in the second period. Pretty good action the last few minutes. Here come the Terriers. Moving quickly left to right. Schuler with the puck. The shot is blocked right in front. She had a lane and she set up for the wrister, but it was blocked by the Warrior defense. 8:45 and counting remaining in this period. BU still with a 2-1 advantage. All 3 goals of the game were scored in the first period. Is Manu. And BU takes it away really quickly. It's back and forth. Here comes D'Souza. Desiree D'Souza, out of Montreal, brings it behind Ridgewell. Elliott takes it away for BU. They're going to keep it in the zone. To Tarnowski, one of the captains for head coach Brian DeRosier. Gran Mentis with the puck, twirling it as she crosses the blue line. Centering pass right to a Terrier defender. No Merrimack player was there. And back and forth we go. Lead pass intercepted by the Warriors. Good defense by McLean. Give it to Bonfi. Bonfi looking for the centering pass. Works to the left. The wrister is blocked. As BU trying to get it out of the zone. Under 7.5 to play in this period. D'Souza collecting it for the Terriers and now getting it out of the zone is Comfort. And it goes behind Ridgewell and we have an icing with 7:09 remaining in this second period. It's been back and forth. A lot of the action in the neutral zone as the score remains the same. Quick opportunity to thank our sponsors of tonight's broadcast. Supercuts, Touchstone Closing, Total Sports Repair, Hockey, Under Armour, WB Mason, and White Street Paint and Wallpaper. Paige Voigt will try to win the faceoff for the Warriors. Brings it back out to Cook. Voigt, quick pass down low, couldn't knock it home, was Bokers. BU knocks it out of the zone. Warriors trying to bring it back in. They do. This is Paige Voigt. Doesn't have numbers. Looking for the trailer, and she has it taken away by Correa. DeCare crossing the blue line right in front, and it's going to be an offsides as Gabby Jones was trying to set it up with her new teammate, and they couldn't quite do it. A faceoff outside of the zone with 6:24 remaining in the second period. Grant Mentis will work against Schuler. Faceoff goes to Gabby Jones. Here comes Katelyn Ray. Ray, cradling the puck. In front, no one there for the Warriors. Coming up on 6 minutes remaining in this period. Warriors doing a good job keeping in the zone. Here comes Katelyn Ray once again. Ray trying to go behind Schroeder. Working into Kramer. Kramer dumped down and couldn't quite knock it home was Grant Mentis. So another faceoff, a lot of faceoffs here in the second period. BU has won 11 faceoffs. Merrimack has won 10. But BU is leading 2-1 on the scoreboard. This faceoff won by Merrimack. This is Katelyn Ray. Her shot is blocked. Here comes D'Souza crossing the blue line. Kramer intercepts it. Pass along the boards. Warriors trying to get it out as we're closing in on 5:15 remaining in this period. BU just knocks it back to Ridgewell. Quick line change for BU. This puck is near center ice. Comfort collects it as she finds Donnelly. Comfort almost lost it. Now behind the net. The wrister by Scarpese was blocked by Burton. Scarpese again, working to the right. This is Cook. Her wrister is blocked right in front. As Warriors trying to get out of the zone, they do. As Maddie Burton will collect it in an offside. And Kiki Roust knew it right away. A few strides right in front of Maddie Burton. We'll have a faceoff at center ice with exactly 4 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the second period. Actually, the faceoff will go just outside the blue line. Morey can't win it for the Warriors. Manu brings it back along the blue line. Finding Bonfield. The shot is collected by Schroeder. The senior, Jessica Bonfield of Woodbury, Minnesota, looking for her second goal of the season. You see on replay the shot collected by Schroeder. 4:20 remaining in the second period. Faceoff won by the Terriers. It's back in the neutral zone. Both teams battling for it. The Warriors control it. It's Chloe Cook who has it along her stick. Find Morey crossing the blue line into the zone. Morey shot. Collected by Schroeder with the glove, and we'll have another face-off to the left of Corinne Schroeder. Schroeder, who was named to the Hockey East All-Rookie team last year as a freshman, had a season-high 35 saves in the tie that BU had just 6 days ago when they hosted Northeastern at Walter Brown Arena. It was a 3-3 tie. We saw 38 shots. Knocked 35 away so far today. She's knocked 11 of the 12 shots away that she's seen. Here come the Terriers. Warriors trying to get out of the zone. McLean. Now it's Sorensen. Behind the net, Sorensen. Trying to clear it to Voigt, and then she gets it out of the zone. Either way works. BU trying to get it back into the zone. Ridgewell just watches that go behind her. Karnowski now at center ice will dump it behind Ridgewell. 3 minutes exactly remaining in the second period. No scoring so far in the first 17 minutes of action in this middle frame. McLean finding Jones. Jones, the freshman, leaving it for Grant Mentis. Grant Mentis centering pass. No one there. It was blocked. Grant Mentis gets it back. Works the left, and the Warriors can't keep it in the zone. .230 and counting remaining in this period. This is Kramer. Kramer crossing the blue line. Kramer with the puck. Back to Jones. Now behind the net. Warriors trying to get it into the center, and no one is there. As Kramer poke checks it away, back into the Terriers' defensive zone as we're under 2 minutes to play in the period. As Ridgewell will just collect it and settle for a face-off just to the left of her. .152 remaining in the second period. BU leading the shots 14-12 and leading the scoreboard 2-1 with two first period goals. Puck loose right in front. Warriors trying to clear it out, and the puck will go right into the stands. Very close to a couple of fans. We'll get a new puck and a new faceoff with 1:42 remaining in the period. Faceoff upcoming. Ferguson trying to win it for Merrimack, and we'll have another faceoff. Happened numerous times today. Worth Rich trying to win it for BU, and she does. This is Allen. Shot blocked. Great block by Voigt. Trying to get it back from her teammate. She does. It's Paige Voigt crosses the blue line. Voigt behind the net. Taken away by the Terriers. And cleared back to center ice. Manu. Here comes Voigt. And she clears it back behind Schroeder. As we have 1:10 remaining in the period. Both teams with chances in this period as we're closing in on the final 60 seconds. Manu, good poke check. Terriers still holding on to it. This is Parker. Parker behind the net. Teams battling for it. Warriors come away with it, but it's Galway. Galway now for the Terriers. The slapper blocked by Katelyn Ray. Ray. The speed skater trying to take it away from Galway. Pushes her all the way back into the zone, and the Warriors have the puck. It's Grant Mentis. Grant Mentis. Now to Katelyn Ray. Centering pass. No one there. It was knocked away at the last moment. Ray now again trying to twirl. The push on Schroeder just kicked aside. Final 13 seconds. The slapper from the point collected by Schroeder. She saw that go right into her glove. And with 8.4 remaining in the period, we'll have a face-off to the right of Corinne Schroeder, who has knocked away every shot so far in this period. It'll be Ferguson trying to win the face-off for the Warriors. Ferguson can't do it. Puck collected to the left. Now it's Schroeder watching it go behind her. Final second ticks away. Horn sounds. Second period in the books right here at Lawler Rink. No scoring here in the second period after both teams lit the lamp in the first period. Merrimack scoring the first goal and BU scoring the last two unanswered in the first period. But no team found the back of the net in the second period. So we'll pause right now as we're at the second intermission here at Lawler Rink, and when we come back, we'll have some more and updated out-of-town scores. We'll have some stats, and we'll have some replays of the scoreless second period. 2-1 here at Lawler Rink. The Terriers on top of the Warriors. Back after this. Welcome back inside Lawler Rink. I'm Greg Kadetsky. Glad you can join us when we're still at the second intermission as BU holds a 2-1 lead over the Merrimack Warriors. Give you a quick refresher of how we got here in the first period. It was Merrimack who started things off. It was Emily Volpe on the power play who got the goal as she just stuck it right behind Corinne Schroeder. And at that moment, Merrimack had a 1-0 lead. Just about 40 seconds later, the BU Terriers got a goal from Abby Cook. It was a wrister from the top right near the blue line. Ridgewell didn't see it. And BU tied it up at 1. And a quick goal there by Abby Cook. 2.5 minutes after that, Reagan Rust got in the action for BU. Just about from the same spot that Cook got the goal 2.5 minutes prior, Reagan Rust got her first goal of the season, and that made it 2-1 Terriers, and that's where we are right now. Shots on goal pretty even, in fact, exactly even, 15 apiece. Warriors 1-for-3 on the power play, and dead even on faceoffs, 1-18 apiece. Though BU has the advantage, 9-7 of blocked shots, and BU has the 1-goal advantage on the scoreboard. And speaking of scoreboard, a quick rundown of the out-of-town scores in men's hockey. The Merrimack Warriors have a 1-0 lead over the Bentley Falcons, that matchup taking place out in Waltham. Across Hockey East, Providence took care of business against the Crusaders of Holy Cross, 5-0. The Friars defeated the Crusaders. Up at New Hampshire in Durham, the Wildcats on top of the Huskies, 3-2. That's at the end of 2. And at Boston College at Connie Forum, the Eagles took care of business and defeated St. Lawrence 2-1 in overtime. Last couple of out-of-town scores, Maine defeating Sacred Heart, 8-0 up in Orono. And in overtime, Vermont and Quinnipiac, a 1-1 tie. The final other hockey's game is Colgate and Northeastern. Colgate on top 2-1. And here we go, final 20 minutes on the clock. And the face-off won by the Terriers. They have the 2-1 advantage and trying to keep it that way for the final 20 minutes. As both teams have switched sides, the Warriors now going left to right on your screen. Glad you can join us. I'm Greg Konetsky. It's been a good battle so far here at Lawler Rink. And that's the 10th meeting between these two schools. BU has the advantage 7-2. Both wins for the Warriors came at Walter Brown Arena. And in fact, the Terriers are looking for the first win this season. 0-1-1 so far. The Warriors have not lost yet. They're 3-0-1, including 2-0 here at Lawler. The deflection shot was saved by Schroeder. Katelyn Ray tried to knock it in on the deflection right in front, and another save by Corinne Schroeder. The 16th shot on goal by the Warriors, the 15th save by Schroeder. Warriors win the face-off. This is Grant Mentis. Work to Chloe Cook. Shot in front. It was deflected. Schroeder barely got that one. She didn't see the deflection. She got her glove right in front of her body. She was able to hold on to the puck. Two straight shots for the Warriors in a matter of seconds. We have our second straight face-off. As Maury pushed aside, Grant Mentis will try to win it. She does for the Warriors. Here come the Terriers, who took it away. This is Worthrich. Terriers keeping it in as we are a minute 15 gone here in the third period. This is Abby Cook. Working into Schuler, taken away by the Warriors. Katelyn Ray trying to race for it. She cannot get it as Cook clears it back out. Goes behind Ridgewell. She's seen two shots go behind her. the two BU goals, all scoring coming in the first period as Ridgewell collects it. BU trying to take it away in the offensive zone. Here comes Sorensen now. Even for Bukalska. Now collected by Gabby Jones, the freshman. Spun around, it was McLean. She had it taken away. The wrister by Tarnowski was just wide. 2.5 gone by, kind of reminiscent of the first period where BU controlled the tempo the first few minutes until Merrimack got on the scoreboard. Due to a power play. First couple of minutes, it's been all on the defensive side of Merrimack. Taken away is Ferguson. Working up to McLean. This is Ferguson again, trying to cut through the Terrier defense. The clear out to Kramer is just a little too much, and Kramer will reset behind Ridgewell. BU putting pressure on. Trying to forecheck it away. This is Kramer. Kramer trying to cut through everybody once again. Now it's BU with a puck. Scarpese crossing the red line, and she'll dump it toward Ridgewell. Just got past the red line, so no icing. There comes Katelyn Ray. Ray trying to get behind the Terrier defense, does, knocks it along the board to Madison Morey. Morey back to Manu. And now the Warriors will reset at center ice and now just dump it in the Terrier zone. And it'll be an icing. As Manu was passed, was behind the red line. So 16:01 remaining in the third period. 17 shots for the Warriors, 15 for the Terriers. Schuler trying to win the face-off for the Terriers. She does. Slap it to the right of Ridgewell. Manu almost losing the puck. This is Grant Mentis trying to get it out of the zone. Are the Warriors. Takes a big hit along the boards. No call. Manu just dumps it behind Schroeder. This one, no penalty. So 15:33 remaining. This one, remaining in the third period. A face-off to the right of Schroeder. Actually, it will be a penalty. Going to the penalty box is Emma Worthrich and of Anchorage, Alaska. So a power play upcoming for the Warriors. They converted on their first one. Volpe trying to win the faceoff. She does to McLean. To the right to Kramer. McLean finding Volpe. Up at the top is McLean. Back to Volpe. The shot blocked right in front. Second opportunity for the Warriors. This is Voigt. Voigt trying to knock in the middle. Puck loose right in front in the crease, and the Warriors can't knock it home. A great opportunity for Merrimack, and they couldn't collect. Voigt battling for the puck. Here comes Ferguson. Ferguson trying to knock it off the boards. Looking for Volpe. Back to McLean. To the right, this is Kramer. Ray trying to keep it in the zone. She does. She finds Kramer along the boards. Kramer falling, now collecting. And Grant Mentis can't keep it from going out into the neutral zone, and a reset for the Warrior offense. Here comes Grant Mentis. Grant Mentis losing the puck right in the middle. Katelyn Ray now getting it. Ray now losing it. 40 seconds remaining in the power play. Warriors 1-for-3 with a man advantage. They're going to make it 2-for-4. This is Cook. Chloe Cook handling the puck. Dropping it off to Jones. Jones back to Grant Mentis. The slapper just wide. Sorensen lined up for that one. Grant Mentis finding Cook. And Scarpese trying to clear it out for the Terriers. As the penalty, the power play has expired. 1-for-4, the Warriors with a man advantage. The centering pass by Jones, no one was there. Great skating by the freshman, Gabby Jones. 13-10 and counting remaining this third period, a very tense third period. As Merrimack trying to tie it up. No call is falling to the ice. It was Morey. Warriors trying to keep it in the zone. They do. This is Bonfey. The shot on Schroeder. What a save by the senior goaltender. The sophomore goaltender making a terrific save. Merrimack loading up some shots on Schroeder. Here comes Manu. Back to Voigt. Voigt, another shot on Schroeder, and she collects it. 21 shots today by the Merrimack women's hockey team. They've only had one shot go by. Schroeder, she's been terrific in net. Ferguson trying to win the faceoff. She cannot. Galway collects it. Elia now for the Terriers, trying to get it out of the zone. She does. This is D'Souza, and we have an offsides. 12:31 remaining in this one. As BU wins the tip in the neutral zone. This is Russ, who had the second goal for BU, and right now that's the difference. This goal with just about 3 minutes remaining in the first period, her first goal of the season. And the second one of BU's today. Shot taking a weird bounce off the boards. Here come the Terriers. Puck goes back into the neutral zone. Sharpezi collects it. And here comes Comfer. Comfer trying to find Davis. The wrist, a great save by Ridgewell. Rebound right there for BU. They couldn't knock it home. Correa was right there. Warriors trying to get it out once again. They can't. 11:30 and counting in this one. As the save by Ridgewell on the shot by Cook. Ridgewell this time saw Cook's shot. Remember in the first period? She did not. And that was BU's first goal of the game. The Warriors trying to put some pressure on. As Comfer can't take the face off once again. This will be Davis for the Terriers as Cook has it. Now the Warriors collect it and now kick it out of the zone. Ray trying to collect it for the Warriors. The really fast skating of Katelyn Ray. Yeah. Here comes Davis for the Terriers. Katelyn Ray just takes it away right in front of the Merrimack bench. Trying to find Grant Mentis. Buck goes off of the boards. And we'll have a face-off. The 10-24. Remaining in the third period, still a 2-1 advantage for the Terriers. We have face-off in the Merrimack zone. The shot on Ridgewell was too close. It was too tough at an angle for BU. Good save there by Ridgewell, the senior goaltender. Puck going off the boards. Here comes Ferguson. Ferguson looking to avoid that shot in front. No one was there, and it was wide of Schroeder. Dakar battling for it along with Ferguson and Voigt. Out of the pack, this is Worthrich. And goes back to the Warriors, closing in on the halfway point of this third period. Dakar collecting the puck. Reset for the Warriors. Volpe with it. Warriors moving quickly. It's McLean, the freshman. We're in it to Maude. Maude's shot deflected. Here come the Terriers, 3-on-2 if they hurry. Tarnowski crossing the blue line. Centering pass, knocked away. Good defense by the Warriors. Ahead is D'Souza. D'Souza, the shot on Ridgewell. She makes the save. And a little extracurricular activities right in front of Samantha Ridgewell, who just made her 18th save of the game. 9:12 remaining in this one. Merrimack looking to tie it up. BU trying to make it a 2-goal advantage. Manu behind the net. Trying to get it out. Warriors trying to collect the puck and get it out of the defensive zone. They do. Now back in the neutral zone. Katelyn Ray trying to chase it down. She can't. Tight defense by the Terriers. And they just knock it back into the Warriors' defensive zone. This is Grant Mentis. Cook. Now to the left to Davis. Taken away by Manu. And we go back and forth. Calling for it is Ferguson. She loses it to Comfort. Comfort to Worthrich. She loses it. Merrimack knocks it back into the zone. Trying to chase it down is Voigt. Here comes BU. Head of steam. This is Schuler as Ridgewell just collects it. And now 8:06 remaining in the third period. Time is becoming the foe of the Warriors. Warriors trying to remain undefeated on the season. 3-0-1, the best start in school history. In a program, though it's only been around for this the fourth year of existence. As we're under 8 minutes to play. Along the boards, this is Dakar. Loses it to Parker for BU. That name very familiar for BU fans, as Jack Parker was the coach of the men's hockey team for many years. As Parker loses it, Warriors trying to keep it in the zone. This is Kramer now. She loses it. And here come the Terriers. And wisely, they just dump it down. And D'Souza, who knocked it behind Ridgewell. Warriors need to put some pressure on the Terriers' defense. As Volpe trying to chase down the puck, Galway knocks it off the boards. Here comes Tarnowski. Dumping it down. Here come the Warriors. Chloe Cook trying to collect it and get it out of their zone. 6:45 and counting remaining in the third period. As this could be icing, and it is. 6:37 remaining in this one. Take a look at head coach Aaron Hamlin. He's been on the helm for Merrimack since this program started 4 years ago. She's in her 11th season of coaching, a product of the University of New Hampshire, where she was a great hockey player. Puck along the boards. The U trying to keep it in the zone. This is Correa. Correa for BU. And now Chloe Cook finds it from Merrimack. Cross ice pass. And it's Scarpese who knocks it off the boards, trying to get it out of the zone for the Terriers, and they do. They might have numbers if they hurry, said Cook, slows it down as we're under 6 minutes to play in the period. The push on Ridgewell, nothing there for BU. Shots 21-17, the Warriors have the advantage, but BU has the advantage on the scoreboard 2-1 with all scoring coming the first period. Cook taking it away from Ferguson. Now it's Schuler. Schuler, the sophomore, going along the boards, working on Ridgewell, trying to dump it past her. She can't. And the Warriors collect the puck right behind the net. It's Dominique Kramer. As the bouncing puck, a little knuckler, it will be icing. So we'll bring it back to the other side of Lawler Rink with 5 minutes and 14 seconds remaining in this one. Face-offs have been pretty even, as that was the 37th face-off of the day. Both teams had won 18. Merrimack won that one, but it's BU now with a puck in the neutral zone. As the puck is actually kind of stopped on top of the boards, but it bounced back into play. It'll stay on the BU offensive zone. Ridgewell makes the kick save at the last moment. Warriors trying to get it out. Sorensen now off the boards, trying to get it out of the zone. She does, and B will reset. It's on the stick of Stanley's. The Warriors change lines, just knock it off the boards. It could be icing, and it is. So we'll move it back to the other side of Lawler Rink with 4:24 remaining in the third period. Quick update. At Northeastern, still Colgate nursing a 2-1 lead over the Huskies. And that's exactly what the Terriers are doing, 2-1 over the Warriors. As a visiting team winning in both of that contest and this one. This is Elia. Behind Ridgewell, Elia will collect it for BU. They're trying to keep it in the zone. This is Tarnowski. Tarnowski with the puck, finding Galway. The 3:45 and counting. Elia trying to find Rust along the blue line. Here come the Warriors. Take the puck away. This is Bonfey. Bonfey trying to work on four Terrier defenders, and she had it poke checked away. This is Maury now. Maury looking for a teammate, finds Katelyn Ray as three Terrier players converge on the two Merrimack players, and it's the Terriers who come away with a puck. It's Abby Cook, the junior out of British Columbia. Puck is cleared back in the direction of Ridgewell with exactly 3 minutes remaining in the period. Period number three, then is BU on top 2-1. BU has won 7 of the previous 9 matches, but it's Katelyn Ray. The shot is a goal! Katelyn Ray going top shelf on Schroeder for her 4th goal of the season and tying this game at 2. Katelyn Ray was just waiting for the opportunity today to get behind the BU defense, and that's exactly what happened. And she just got past the last defender, and her speed gets by BU, and she went top shelf to tie this game at 2. Big goal for Katelyn Ray and the Warriors. Now it's the Terriers on their back skates. It's BU trying to knock it in the zone, trying to keep it there. This is Parker for the Terriers. Parker centering pass, no one there. 2:15 to play in the third period. Now we're tied at 2. We were tied briefly earlier, but only for 2.5 minutes in the first period. So this is the lone goal since that first period, which saw the first 3 goals of this contest. As the Warriors will go on a line shift as we're under 2 minutes remaining in regulation. As Donnelly batting for it, this is Katelyn Ray once again. Katelyn Ray, the centering pass to Grant Mendes, just wide. The shot again is just wide. Grimetas, another one, kicked away by Schroeder. Another opportunity for the Warriors. They're putting pressure on the sophomore goaltender. The shot is in the crease, and no one could knock it home once again. Warriors putting a lot of pressure on the Terrier defense. Grant Mentis. The wrister on Schroeder. She collects it. No rebound on the 24th shot of the game by the Merrimack Warriors. 1:07 to play in regulation. We'll have a face-off to the right of Schroeder. The Ferguson will line up against Comfer. Face-off won by the Warriors. Sorensen's slapper is just above Schroeder. Getting his Cook for BU, trying to get it out of the zone. This is Comfer now. Comfer has it taken away as Merrimack just dumps it back into the zone, final 45 seconds. Voigt trying to chase it down for the Warriors. Great pressure by the Warriors over the last few minutes. They have the puck. An opportunity. And somehow Schroeder gets it. Back and forth. What an opportunity for the Warriors in the final moments. It was Ferguson, a 2-on-1, and she whiffed, and Schroeder just picked up the puck. And now with 32 seconds remaining, another face-off to the right of Schroeder. Grant Mentis will try to win it for the Warriors. She cannot. And BU will just clear it out of the zone, and it could be icing. They wave the icing, so 20 seconds remaining. See if Merrimack can bring it down on the other side of Lawler Rink. Final 15 seconds. They had an opportunity 15 seconds ago. But for the final 8, now 7 seconds, we might be going to overtime. as BU one last rush as the horn will sound as the end of regulation has taken place. It is Merrimack 2 and BU 2, thanks to the goal by Katelyn Ray with just a few minutes remaining in this one. What a way to do it for the Warriors, finally getting Katelyn Ray loose. Quick two-minute break before we'll restart everything and one overtime period. Both teams have played in overtime so far this season. Warriors in their third game of the season and the first one out in Penn State 1 week ago. They ended up in a 1-1 tie against the Nittany Lions. For the BU Terriers, their second game of the season, their previous game, was a 3-3 tie against the Northeastern Huskies. So it's the second overtime game of the season so far for both squads. Don't forget, for the Warriors, for their next five games will be on the road, including against Boston College at Conti Forum 1 week from now. For the BU Terriers, they're looking to continue their success they've had for the last number of years. They went to the Hockey's tournament last year. They lost to Maine in Game 3 in overtime, which ended their season. Merrimack did not make the playoffs last year. They finished in the ninth seed, and that's the only seed that does not get a seed in the playoff bracket. Previous year, they were the eighth squad, the first time they made it in their second year of existence. And Merrimack looking to get back into the playoffs and make some noise. This is their fourth year. And a lot of returning players, led by Katelyn Ray, who tied this game with just a few minutes remaining. So Merrimack will go right to left, BU will go left to right, and we're set to go for overtime. Comfer and Ferguson, 5 minutes on the clock, and we're set to go in the extra session. Puck dropped. Still battling for it right at center ice, and here comes BU. Decaire was trying to hold on to it, and we'll have a whistle just 16 seconds into overtime. So they're going to signal it as icing, so it goes back to the other end of Lawler Rink. Trying to win the faceoff is Emily Volpe. Volpe cannot win the faceoff. BU wins it. As Comfort collects it, goes along the boards and now out into the neutral zone. Kramer trying to collect it. She knocks it back into the BU's territory. Grant Mentis now centering pass off of Schroeder. Cook now to the left. The wrister knocked away by Schroeder once again. 26 shots on the game for the Warriors. This is Davis. Davis stopping behind Ridgewell. 1 minute gone by here in overtime. 4 minutes remaining. The wrister just by Ridgewell. She didn't see it. Ferguson now. Ferguson looking into the neutral zone. Grant Mentis knocks it down. An opportunity for the Warriors if they collect the puck, but it just sneaks back into the neutral zone. Here come the Terriers. Good poke check away by Katelyn Ray. As it'll be a race to the puck, collecting it is Scarpese. .320 and counting remaining in the extra session. Collecting it is Schroeder. BU will set up their offense. Merrimack putting on full defense right now. Here comes Katelyn Ray. Ray losing the puck into the neutral zone. BU just knocks it back down as Ridgewell collects it. Here comes BU once again. This is Allen, almost puck going out. Instead, it stays in as Morey loses it to D'Souza. Here comes Desiree D'Souza. To the cross of the blue line, centering pass, taken away by the Warriors. Ahead of the pack, and all alone, this is Voigt. The shot is just wide of Schroeder. Voigt had an opportunity to win it. Here comes BU. Going the other way, Ridgewell knocks it away. 2:15 and counting to play in overtime. Sorensen now. Working it to Volpe. Volpe along the boards all the way to Schroeder under 2 minutes to play in overtime. As Warriors collect the puck, we're going to Katelyn Ray off the board. As Rust regains it for BU. Pass in the middle, knocked down momentarily. Here comes Comfort, shot blocked by Ridgewell. What a save with a pad. Warriors trying to get it out of the zone. Scarpese up top, Stanley, shot blocked right in front. Here's Katelyn Ray, 2-on-2 if the Warriors hurry. Instead knocked off the skate of Jones. Exciting overtime here as Ridgewell makes the save in front. An opportunity for a moment by Sammy Davis, the redshirt junior. As we see on replay, these teams have gone back and forth in overtime. The replay was Paige Voigt's opportunity, and you can see Schroeder just got a little bit of the pad on it and knocked it above her. Faceoff won by Merrimack. 70 seconds remaining in overtime. This is Werthrich. Stanley's one-timer is just off. Here comes Voigt. Ahead of the pack to Grant Mentis. Grant Mentis with the puck. The shot is knocked aside and it goes off of the netting. So we'll have a faceoff with 47.9 seconds remaining. Very good and entertaining overtime. Faceoff will be to the left of Schroeder. Ferguson will try to win it for Merrimack. Schuler has other ideas. Faceoff won by the Terriers. Merrimack trying to knock it home. It went up and almost behind Schroeder. Half the bench thought it was in. Ray's shot collected by Schroeder, and we have a faceoff. As we look at that last replay, a crazy turn of events. If you watch the puck, I think it went behind Schroeder, but no one saw it. She didn't know where it was. And either way, with 32.2 seconds remaining, well, a faceoff to the left of Corinne Schroeder. It'll be Ferguson and Comfort. Behind Ferguson is Kramer. She's lining up. She wants that faceoff to be won by Ferguson, or a one-timer. Faceoff won by the Terriers along the backboards. And here come the Terriers. This is Comfer now, leaving into Korea. The shot in front collected by Ridgewell with 18.2 seconds remaining. Everyone biting their fingernails, sitting on the edge of their seats here in overtime. These teams have never tied. It's the 10th meeting between them. Manu gets the puck, and she will try to clear it out, and she does. Final 10 seconds ticking away here in overtime. Final 5 seconds, maybe one last rush for the Terriers. Out of the pack, Ridgewell knocks it away with her stick with the final second ticking away, and the final horn sounds to indicate this has been a tie between the Warriors and the Terriers. A very well-played game by both teams, and for the first time in history, these two teams end the game with the same score and a tie. 2-2 was the final here at Merrimack as the Terriers and the Warriors end this game with a tie. And the Warriors remain undefeated on the season now, 3-0-2. The Terriers still winless on the season, 0-1-2. And now 0-1-2 in Hockey East, whereas the Warriors are 0-0-1 in Hockey East. It was a very entertaining game. First three goals of this game took place in the first period. Merrimack bookending the game with their goals. BU had the two ones in the middle, which gave them the lead. Did BU? They had the lead until about 2.5 minutes remaining in this game, until Katelyn Ray tied this game at 2, and that's how we ended things. As both teams thanking the crowd, a well-played game and a very good game here to call. As a quick rundown of the scores, Emily Volpe in the first period for Merrimack, then Abby Cook and Reagan Rust for BU, and then Katelyn Ray in the final minutes of this game that tied this game at 2, and no scoring after that, and we ended the game with a tie. So for everyone that helped out tonight, the final here at Lawler Rink, 2-2 between Merrimack and BU. So long, everybody.